So white pine is one of our most common trees. It's an evergreen tree, a conifer, one of these tree species with needles. And people get it confused with all kinds of different things, but it's actually really simple to identify it. So the first thing to look for is needles. Now, white pine, unlike all of Vermont's other common conifers, have these really long, delicate green needles. They're the only really common species of conifer that has long needles like this. The aggregation of all of those long, delicate needles gives pine foliage this really soft, cloud-like appearance. So when I look up in pine trees, and usually the needles are way up in the top of the tree, it just looks like these soft clouds of green coming off the branches. White pine bark is kind of purple-black. When they get older, they can break up into these broad, flat ridges. When they're younger, they just look kind of chippy like this. Another characteristic that they have that they share with most of our other conifer species, but not with hemlock, is that their branches are in whorls. A whorl is just a circle of branches that the white pine grows around their trunk, and they grow one per year. So if you can count the number of whorls, it'll tell you how old that pine tree is. While a really happy and healthy white pine tree will have a single straight trunk, most white pine trees in Vermont look like this. We call them old field pines or cabbage pines, pasture pines. The reason for that is that when white pine trees are growing in the open, they can get attacked by this insect called the white pine weevil. Kills their terminal bud, their top bud that tells it to grow straight up. Two of those lateral buds will become the new terminal buds and form two trunks, and it gets attacked again and again, and so you can get these really crooked, wonky looking trees. White pine trees have an interesting cultural history here in North America. They were one of the first things that European colonists noticed about this continent, something they really coveted, these big, tall white pine trees. In fact, they declared all the biggest white pine trees at one time to be the property of England. And that's thought to be one of the things that incited the American Revolution. So today we have all these pine forests everywhere, often with those weird, crooked looking pasture pines. In a lot of cases, those aren't even sites where white pine can be healthy in the long term. White pine is just there as an opportunist. It happens to be a species that's good at growing in old fields. So on our landscape, there's a lot more white pine here than there used to be. One of the neat things about counting the whorls on a white pine tree and telling how old it is that will also tell you the number of years ago that the forest you're standing in was a pasture. So if you're looking at a white pine tree and you go up the tree and you count 50 whorls, 50 years ago that was a pasture. Today those pasture pines are getting older and we have these big windstorms. A lot of pasture pines blow over and people freak out about it. They say, oh my God, what's happened to my forest? And for a lot of us, ecologists, foresters, biologists, it's actually really exciting. Because those pasture pines, while they performed a really important ecological service, transitioning that pasture back into a forest, a lot of times they're not a good representation of what wants to be there in the long term. The diversity of species that make up a healthy Vermont forest. And so a lot of times it's our job to go out there when all those pines are laying on the ground and say, wow, this is so exciting. If you like that video, please like and subscribe.